Carly Fossey, the lovely Carly Fossey.
Okay, so I had the privilege of performing at my high school this weekend. This week, not weekend. And we had something going on. It's called Mac Night. It's a multicultural awareness night. And it was interesting to go there and to see all these different cultures. And I remember watching one dance and being like, Lord bless them. Just because it's so different and there's so many different spirits that I believe were in that room that night. And anyways, I was very reluctant to actually accept the offer to do my performance last night. I was very reluctant. I was like, God, is this what you want me to do? Because I knew I was going to be walking into an atmosphere that's very different from a church atmosphere. But God just set it up. He was like, yeah, go do it. I went there with my friend Asa Lane from the States. Lord bless him. It was because of that amazing drummer. He's a percussionist. It's thanks to him that the night went as well as it did. We sat and we prayed before we got up there. I was one of the last acts to go up, and we just let it rip for Jesus, man. We worshiped, we gave it our all. Afterwards, I had like chills all over me, like it was intense. But even more amazing was what I've heard that has happened after that night. First of all, my teacher, who was the one who told me to do that night, he looked at me afterwards, he's like, and he announced, because he was the announcer for the night, he was the MC, he announced, that's what I call soul music, which is true, man, it's Jesus music, it is for our spirits, right? And then I found out today, actually, that there was this young Middle Eastern girl, I'm not sure exactly what culture she was from, it seemed East Indian, and she said she and her family were actually there. And she said that her parents started to weep as God entered that room and as I was singing. And so I just want to give God all the glory for last night and for what he's doing in our students' high schools, man. The high schools are getting blessed with the glory of God. And it's thanks to people like Mike Fleischer and Pastor Josh who have been praying for this city and laboring. And I just encourage you guys to get in on this. If you're prayer warriors, keep praying, keep interceding for our young people because we need it. We're going to be getting up in our high schools and it's going to be God's glory all over this city and all over our young people that's going to bring. So yeah, I'm greatly encouraged and I hope that you guys are too.
All right.
Lord, we just pray for Northern High School right now. And Lord, we just ask for your, just thank you that you're going to just continue to work in that school. Bless Carly Fossey. Thank you. She's standing up on a multicultural awareness night and worshiping you boldly, ushering your presence into that place. Amen. Let's take a couple more. Just hold it for the moment.
I've been waiting for a phone call from Harvey's, and today Amy was working, and Carol wanted to talk to me, and I start next week, and I've been praying for a job for like 6 months now.
Discount burgers.
Yeah.
So, not last week, but the week before, I had a meeting with Pastor Josh, and it was a lot to do with, like, just how things were going with myself, and, like, I've been, like, told so much lately just to go and, like, evangelize to people, and I've just been really scared, and I was like, I'm not doing that, and I told him, like, I was like, I feel really crappy afterwards, and he was like, well, just go and do it, don't care what people think, and just do it, like, God's opinion matters more than anyone else's. And that kind of clicked, and then that made me think of something he said. I think it was at River City, I think the Sunday before. He said that God's love is supposed to be a river, not a swamp. supposed to flow through us and not just like mellow in us and like just like get all gross and stuff. And so I was on my way home and I saw these two guys and I drove right past them and I was like, I'm not going to talk to them. And then I started slowing down really slowly and I couldn't even like stop myself. I'd slow down, speed up, but eventually I stopped in the middle of London Road and I turned into a parking lot and I turned around and I went back to go talk to them. And I was talking to this one guy and he was really cool and I gave him, I didn't give him a card, I didn't have any on me. But yeah, I talked to him and he was like, when I saw him walking, he was kind of like going like that, holding his back. And I was like, does your back hurt or like do you have any pain? And he's like, yeah, my back's like killing me. He's like, I hurt it the other day. So I asked him if I could pray for him and I prayed and his back got completely healed.
Since I've been coming here, I've had more joy in my life. Because I've been in a real, dry spot, and I have no more. I sat alone always on Friday nights, feeling having self pity parties. All alone. But since that, I've been here. The ladies in our women's group on Tuesday mornings. Seen a difference in my life, and so Sunday morning, last Sunday morning in the nursery, I was doing nursery, and the one lady, Deb, says, I want more of that joy too, so she asked me to pray over her right there in the nursery, so it's not like me to do all that, and then pray for the girl that was helping me, and then on Tuesday morning in the women's group, they wanted me to pray for somebody else, so it's just like
some
news happening. Like,
Hi, it's my first night out, but I just moved. Yeah, I was at the men's group this week. I was at Ottawa for the last 5 years and just moved back to Sarnia where I grew up. But about 3 weeks ago, 3 or 4 weeks ago, I was in Cuba on a humanitarian trip with my church in Ottawa. And we witnessed to, we were working with the Methodist church there, so we traveled all over the eastern part of the island. And we were there for 11 days, and we had two teams of 10 people. And between the two teams, we saw 71 people come to Christ. In Cuba, that's their everyday life. That's normal for them. They weren't shocked at all. But we were so touched by God. And at one of the last meetings, I prayed for a woman who was suffering from depression. And within seconds, just the joy of the Lord filled her. And she just started shaking and fell down. Like she was just filled with the Holy Spirit. Like 15, 20 minutes later, a man who was blind in his left eye was healed. Complete sight.
What was that? Middle of February. Come on, man. That's
I felt like the Lord said, I want you to go preach to 10 people every day. Just go for it. So we started doing that. We were trying. We didn't get it every day, but some days we got more than 10. We got like 20 or 30. We just going out and planting seed and telling people about Jesus, and it was awesome. We picked up this one guy to give him a drive to actually River City Vineyard because he volunteered there. And he had tremendous pain in his back. And I didn't know it at the time, but he was actually totally blind in one eye. It was his right eye. And long story short, we were talking to him, we ended up praying for his back, and God totally, completely healed his back. And then we found out he had lost sight. He was 19, when he was 16, he jumped off a one-story car park, like parking lot thing, on his rollerblades, and fell down, smashed his head, and he went totally blind in his right eye. Left, I was fine, but it was probably some some neuron damage or whatever, neurological damage. And so we prayed, put my thumbs in his like eye sockets, like not right in, but like press like on his eyeballs. And
His eyelids.
yes, you know what I mean. He's smiling. And so, long story, we prayed for him, and the power of God came. I don't know if I've ever felt the anointing of the Holy Spirit so strong as in that moment. And God, he opened his eye, and his eye was totally, completely healed.
Yeah.
100% vision. Just go for it. As believers realize, you have the power of the Holy Spirit in you. Give it away. Give it away. Last thing, I just got this email March 23rd, which would have been 2 days ago, just in the morning. There was a woman that visited with her couple kids. She was from Kitchener. She said, "Greetings, Pastor Pitka. I recently attended your church, and I must say, I have not been the same since. I came home and shared the YouTube information on your church with one of our youth, with one of our youth helpers. She was so impressed that she strongly recommended we load up as many of our youth as we can and bring them to a Friday night service.
Yeah.
I also hope to visit your church more frequently. The only downfall is distance. Kitchener's like, what, 2 hours drive from here? I also hope to visit your church more frequently. That is why I'm so glad you do the vlogs. I do video vlogs 5 days a week. They are a great encouragement. May God continue to lead you and bless you as you serve him. Thank you, Nadine."
Yeah.
So that was really cool. Alright, we'll have these baptism people get ready. Actually, what we're going to do, let me just say this first. As we get that we can go one day at a time, Mike, just one day, let's do today. Tomorrow, tonight we'll get a good night's sleep, we'll wake up early and we'll do it all again. As we realize that we can go one day at a time into the voice of God and just doing whatever he says to do, there's nothing that can stop the Church of Jesus Christ. There's no power in heaven and earth that can stop the church from advancing and kicking the darkness out of this city and filling this city with the glory of God.
Yeah.
The only thing that stops us is us.
Yeah.
Our apathy, our whatever. What? Our mindsets, whatever. If we get hungry and thirsty for the power of God and the presence of God, give ourselves completely to his word and completely to his voice, obey him with everything inside of us, nothing can stop you. Nothing can stop us. The church is called to be the unstoppable force of light and love and glory that fills and permeates the earth.
Yeah.
That's what we're called to do.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
You guys with me?
Amen.
Okay. Yeah. I got like 3 people saying yes.
Woo!
You're like, that's not my testimony. Jump in the river tonight. Jump in the grace of God and start going there.
Yeah.
With all your heart, with everything you are. It's time. And so, awesome. We're going to take our offering and then we're going to baptize.